Vamos a comenzar con la entrevista con John McCormick desde Ginebra.
Well, John, thank you very much for taking the time. You just came back from Geneva. Pretty exciting show, huh?
It was a terrific show, yeah. Very exciting. A nice, interesting balance of the usual exotic supercars and a whole raft of new small cars and mini cars that has an individual appeal. So it was a good show.
Yeah, I guess Geneva is known by that. Like, and I guess that's why Lamborghini always picks it to show their newest thing, and that Huracan looks pretty sharp, huh?
Yeah, the Huracan was a lot better than last year. They had the Veneno, which was sort of looked like a Batmobile and is a bit crazy. But this year, the Huracan is a nice successor to the Gallardo. And also, of course, McLaren had the 650S, which looked great, and is apparently quite an amazing car. And then there were some truly out there cars like the Koenigsegg 1, which is claimed to be now the world's fastest car with 1,400 horsepower and 400 kilometers per hour top speed.
Yeah, and when you see those kind of super performing cars, you can see the industry is recuperating pretty fast, pretty good, right?
Yeah, that's a sort of indicator. I mean, in some of those cars, they've got, you know, fairly limited production, a few hundred, and they claim they've all been sold already. So, and I saw some financial report that there are more billionaires in the world now than, you know, there have ever been, and their numbers are increasing fast. So I think there's plenty of takers for those kind of cars.
Yeah, I think Mr. Stefan Winkerman said that the Lamborghini Huracan has 1,000 orders already before it was even shown. That's crazy.
Yeah. I know. And you know, when you consider that some of these cars are into seven-figure prices, it's remarkable that they can sell them so quickly.
Yeah, amazing. So, other interesting news, I think it was the new Jeep small version. What is it called? Renegade. The Renegade, which is, I guess, is based now on the 500L platform, because they're just going to be made in Italy, right?
That's right, yeah. So Jeep obviously is doing well these days overall, and they've decided to kind of move into the small crossover market. Personally, I wasn't too excited by the design of the Renegade, but, you know, the interior was good. By all accounts, that market is doing very well, that segment of the market. So I'm sure with the Jeep name, it'll sell strongly. I just think they could have done a bit of a better job with the exterior design.
Yeah. And in any case, I mean, I haven't seen it. I wasn't in Geneva. Obviously, I've seen pictures. And in any case, I think it's a much better version of the smaller SUVs that they had in the past, like the Compass and the Liberty and all those things that weren't really, really successful.
That's true, yeah. The last batch of sort of smaller Jeeps, which were still bigger than the Renegade, such as a Compass, have definitely not been their best work for quite a while. The Compass, the Patriot, and those were, you know, the less appealing of Jeeps in recent years. But I'm hoping that they've got more stuff to come, that they're really going to get back on track in the design sense.
Yeah, and now I think with being with merged with Fiat, I think they're going to really, really take advantage of both ends of technology and knowledge and like things to really come up with better cars, no?
Yes, overall, I mean, it's been a bit hit and miss so far, but I think, you know, once they get into the groove, they will start producing some better cars already. The Chrysler 200 that was shown in Detroit is far better than its predecessor, so they're showing signs of progress.
Yeah. So we're talking to John McCormick, who is the director of the World Car of the Year Award of Europanel, and also works for AOL Autos and Detroit. Which one is it? Detroit Times?
Detroit News.
News, I'm sorry. Detroit News. So, speaking of the business of the World Car of the Year Award, every year for the past 10 years, right, they have announced the finalist for the award that is going to be presented finally in New York in April. So can you, John, please tell us a little bit about the list?
Yeah, sure. What happens is at the Geneva show, we announced the three finalists in the various categories we have. And actually, the winner is already known, but not to us. That's just known to the accounting company, and will be revealed at the New York Auto Show in April. But so the overall World Car of the Year, the finalists were the Audi A3, BMW 4 Series, and the Mazda 3. So an interesting little grouping there. Obviously, two sort of more higher-end German marks, and then the more affordable Mazda 3. I think I'm very pleased the Mazda 3 made it, because I think Mazda's been doing really good design work and engineering work in the recent years, and the Mazda 3 in its class, to me, is clearly the most interesting and then fun to drive car.
Yeah, it's one of those cars that when I drove it, I mean, like, from even like the feeling of the steering wheel, it feels like a solid, good, really reliable car, just from that feeling, and then the performance is supports that.
Yeah, exactly. So it's an enthusiast car, and I think I'm pleased that my fellow jury members have decided that was eligible as well.
Yeah, so for this year, the awards expanded to five categories, right? So now we have World Luxury Car of the Year too?
Yes, we added a new category this year, World Luxury Car, and in that category, the finalists were the Bentley Flying Spur, Mercedes S-Class, and the Range Rover Sport. They're all good, very good vehicles. I drove the Spur most recently, and very impressed with its refinement and smoothness, and it of course is a bit overshadowed in some areas by the S-Class, which has so many systems on it, safety systems and comfort features, that it's you probably need about 6 months just to learn everything the S-Class can do.
It's an amazing car. I'm sorry, World Performance Cars of the Year, the Chevrolet Stingray, the Ferrari 458 Speciale, and the Porsche. Porsche seems to be there every year.
Yes, Porsche sort of has a pass to get in with whatever they do. I'm most excited about the Corvette being in there, because I really think the C7, the 7th generation Corvette, is a spectacular arrival in and by far the better than the previous Corvette generation Corvette. And as a US-based juror for the World Car of the Year, I'm very pleased to see an American entry in there. I was a bit disappointed that the Cadillac CTS didn't get into the World Car of the Year finalists.
I know. And the Corvette the Corvette already won the North American Car of the Year award, so maybe you could make it in the World Performance Car of the Year too. Then two more categories. Yeah. Sorry, John, we have like 1 minute left here. We have the World Green Car of the Year, again, an Audi, a BMW, and a Volkswagen.
That's correct.
And then
the World Design is a BMW i3, which is also in the green car, and Mazda 3 again, that's great for its design, and the C-Class Mercedes.
Yeah. And again, I didn't mention it at the beginning, but I have to thank John and the rest of the members of the World Car of the Year Award, because for the first time this year, I'm have the honor of being a juror too, based here in the U.S. So thank you very much for that, John. And so we will see in New York the winners, and hopefully it's going to be pretty exciting show, right?
Absolutely, yes. It's always good fun to be there, and I welcome you to the jurors, and we look forward to seeing you there.
Yeah. And John, where can our audience can find more about your work, please?
Yes, we have a website, wcoty.com, and you can learn all about the details of the awards on that.
And about you, what about your own things?
Sorry?
Your own publications.
Oh, yes. And for me, as I say, you can learn about more about me at the Detroit News, at detnews.com, and some of the other publications I work for also listed there.
Thank you very much, John, and I'll see you in New York. Hopefully the weather will be better. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.